I'ma keep it a bean. Stick to script every scene. This from last year, but they clean. Say to say, I'ma take something else, but it's winning team. Charlie Sheen. Fam gang, the regime. I'm from Piney Green.
What's good? I'm Sheltron, but you can call me Coach, and I'm back at again with a brand new video. And I'ma keep it a bold, brave biscuit. What you see is not always what you get. And even though we saw the O-line not play all that well in the preseason, we can talk about vanilla play calling or whatnot, you know, our checkdowns and quick slants, but that doesn't really have all that much to do with the blocking scheme. Even though we saw some pretty, it wasn't very encouraging blocking from the guys up front, there is reason to believe we can still have a very good O-line going into the season. But before I get into all that, I want to mention a couple things here just before we get into the O-line and how the guys are going to be playing this season. First of all, I have about 3 videos, including this one, planned for, I guess, today and the next couple days. There's this one, there is a record prediction video, and then the preview video of the Panthers versus the Rams. That game's on Sunday. But as some of you guys might know, if you live on the coast or you live in North Carolina or whatever, there is a hurricane coming. I think it's like, I don't know, in Florida right now. It's supposed to be coming to North Carolina here in the next couple of days or whatever. I live like 20 minutes off the coast. And you've been around for a year on this channel, you know that last year I got caught up in the hurricane as it was happening. I stayed here and I lost power for like 5 days, and it was like kind of a weird situation there. And there was a lot of damage, not to my spot, but like everywhere in like a half mile radius, there was some sort of damage. Long story short, it was bad. And depending on how crazy this one looks, I might have to end up dipping out, going to Charlotte maybe today, tomorrow. So if I don't get around to actually uploading those videos in a timely fashion, just know it's not because I'm not making the videos. It's probably for a much bigger reason than that. Now, honestly, by the time it gets to North Carolina, I don't think it's going to be a big storm, but last time it kind of got crazy, and 5 days no power was not for me. But on a lighter note, when I do that game preview, I will be drawing the winner of the 5K subscriber giveaway. I know some of y'all thought I forgot about it. It's for a size medium Cam Newton hoodie jersey. It's all hand stitched, really high quality from the guys at House of Hoodies. And the way you enter the giveaway is you go to my Facebook page. It's facebook.com/Sheltron. Find the post with a giveaway. Actually, I haven't been posting on there very much at all. Unless you're on Twitter, you know I am bad at social media. Sorry about that, guys. I'll try to be more active on that Facebook page, but look, it is what it is. Find that post. It's up near the top, and just comment, keep pounding for a chance to win a free hoodie jersey. It's real soft, real warm, good for cold weather, all that. Check it out. Anyway, let's go on to PIP right now and check out this article from Pro Football Focus. Title says, PFF rankings, all 32 NFL offensive line rankings after the NFL preseason. Now, this is pretty interesting here. We have the Eagles first, no surprise there. Cowboys second. Those two are pretty interchangeable to me. I like both those. Steelers, we know about the Steelers O-line. Titans, Colts, which is kind of tough because the Colts just last year finally got a good O-line. Then Andrew Luck retired. I understand it. I don't blame the man at all. He been through the ringer. I ain't gonna hold you. Then the Saints, which is going to be a tough one for us as well. The Packers, Patriots, Bears. That's going to be crazy because they have a really good front seven on defense and a top 10 offensive line. That's going to be a real big one for the guys in the NFC North. But then we get to 10. 10, the Carolina Panthers. And the little write-up here says, second round pick Greg Little is still in concussion protocol. But if he has to have his number called at some point in the season, he looked more than capable. He only allowed 4 pressures on 82 pass blocking snaps this preseason. Now, it's real interesting here that they focus on Greg Little and not someone who's a starter. Although, you know, Greg Little is a very important piece to our offensive line moving forward. And I would not be all that surprised if he had to come in at some point this season. But between the guys who have moved positions, like Darrell Williams going from right tackle to left tackle, or maybe a guy like Matt Paradis, who we just picked up this offseason and he's coming off of injury, or maybe even a guy who was a backup who won the starting role last year and then kept his spot at left guard, like Greg Van Roten. We have a lot of guys here who have a lot of really great talent. I mean, we have Taylor Moten, we have Trey Turner. Up and down our starting unit for our O-line, we have great blockers. Not just guys who can run block, but guys who are also really good at pass blocking as well. So we have a really good chance, just talent-wise, to be definitely a top 10 offensive line unit. But it's not about talent, really. It's not about singular talent. when you talk about the O-line, it's about how these guys work as a unit. It's about knowing what the protection is, what your assignment is, and being able to identify things as they're happening, or really pre-snap, but not getting fooled on different things. That's going to be the biggest issue here. And honestly, we could talk about how the season is on Cam and about his throwing shoulder, but in a way, you could really say that translates to the season really being on the shoulders of the offensive line. So not only can we be a top 10 offensive line this season, we might have to be a top 10 offensive line and not only prevent sacks, but try to also prevent hits on the quarterback, because not every time a quarterback gets hit, it's a sack. Dudes get hit all the time after the ball is released, and it's still legal, and that's okay. That's part of football. But those hits add up too. Those hits might actually, those probably add up more so than the actual sacks. But we're looking at a situation where we need all five of these guys, and then our blocking tight ends and whatever the guys who come in afterwards. We need all these guys to be in sync, to be in rhythm, and to be at the top of their game. I want to say it's kind of a luxury to be a top 10 O-line here, but it might actually be a necessity for our top guys on our O-line to be one of the best in the league. I think we're capable of it, and I think that with how fast our passing game is going to be and how good and how diverse our running backs are, we can probably mitigate some of the pressure that we get on Cam, and the guys up front won't necessarily have to block for too long on passing or even running downs, but we're going to need them to be on top of their game, and in the preseason, we didn't get that. But I'm sure that in the regular season, we will see some really good progression from these dudes. These guys have experience. They have talent. We know who they are, man. But that's how I feel about it, man. What are your thoughts? Do we have a top 10 O-line? Will we have a top 10 O-line? Or will Cam get hurt or hit a lot this season? Let me know all your thoughts in the comments below. And you already know what to do with that like button.
Cheers to you. Appreciate the chance. Being told y'all I've been the man. Being told y'all I had the gift. Tell a friend to tell a friend. Real ones gonna recommend. Count this as another win.